My name is Bobby McGee from BobbyMcGee.com. I'm standing outside the Boulder YMCA, a beautiful, almost spring day, late winter day in Boulder. And I'm going to talk about the concept that I'm going to be presenting in my course called the Magic Mesocycle. Now, periodization gets a real bad name sometimes because, you know, most folks out there don't periodize their training. They're just hoping for some consistency. They get out every day. They sometimes do exactly the same thing day in and day out and don't realize that, you know, humans are so amazingly adaptable that they will eventually gain very little benefit from doing exactly the same thing every single day. And so the purpose of periodization is to change the stimulus, but at the same time aim it towards a peak event, a supercompensation event. So we want to work hard enough so that we break ourselves down in order to recover more strongly than before. And when we do that, we supercompensate and we reach periods in our season where we are stronger and better than at any other given time. Yet if you look at the top runners and the top triathletes in the world, they're aiming at a period of training which they want to master, which is the key to them, and it shows them what they are capable of. And so what people do when they have that magic mesocycle, people like Emma Snosol, who won the gold medal in the Beijing Olympics in the triathlon, she basically did the same week worth of training for 8 years. And that's not 52 weeks a year. The whole concept with a magical mesocycle is to find a period of training that indicates that you're in the best shape of your season. And what you're trying to do there is to get to a point where you train yourself up to be able to handle that mesocycle. And so one of the things that's so wonderful about that is that's how you periodize. So should you find during the execution of that mesocycle, whether that be 1 week or whether that be 10 days or whether that be 2 weeks, however that period of time is where you go in a cycle and you keep on repeating it, is to find out what's not working in there. Are you not strong enough? Is your endurance lacking? Are you lacking some flexibility? Are you lacking race pace work? Do you need to do some training in some other kind of regard? And what you then do is you design another mesocycle, a supportive mesocycle that helps you go through that specific thing where you place an emphasis, say, on your strength, on your power, on your endurance, in order to get back to that magic mesocycle again. So, you know, a microcycle is what you do in one session or in one day, and a mesocycle is that cycle of all of the training sessions that you want to do in a given period of time and then repeat those again. And so as the weeks and months go by, you keep working on that mesocycle with your recovery. Obviously, you want to have a base period leading into that mesocycle, but that's your key training phase. And what you're trying to do is not necessarily always go faster there, but manage that key training phase a little better. Maybe do a little more as your body adapts and your capacity for training starts to increase. And then your macrocycle is all of those mesocycles that lead up to that specific event, or especially if that's the peak event of your season or of your year, that is your macrocycle. All of those put together, your rest periods plus your magic mesocycle plus your developmental mesocycles in order to do your magic mesocycle plus your base period. And those are all mixed together in your macrocycle. So yes, wishing you the ability to realize very quickly what your specific individualized recipe is and what you need to do to be able to execute that recipe to perfection so that race day turns out to be everything that you want it to be.